Countryside. Way back from Rawson Chapel. We'll zoom out a little bit here. Some countryside shots for you, Jim. Jimmy. Bus tour today in Edinburgh, hop on, hop off, like we did in Amsterdam? Somewhere. We did Amsterdam. And also going shopping. I'm going to do some walkabout to the shops and various things. Is that okay? Hang on. It is. Cool. And get some breakfast. I'm gonna ride the tour bus. We're also going to the Masonic building in Edinburgh, which is on 96 George Street. Super excited about that, actually. So we will be back. We are at the Palace of Hollyrood House. I don't know. I think we can take pictures of the outside of the palace, but not so much the inside. There is the gate and the cool fountain-y thing. The Q-ticket scanner. Not that that's relevant. And we'll be back in just a moment. This is the Palace of Hollyrood. And look at the fountain. What? That's weird. Commentary. Now we can't take pictures or video inside, but hey, 1861. We will be going through. Check out these awesome statues. Fountain. It's a fountain. Well, we're going to be back after this. I can't show you much inside. Maybe we'll pull up some pictures online later. Who knows? As a final shot, we'll show you this cool crest, and then we'll be back later. All right. Just finished the Palace Hollyrood. Tour. Outside, we're in the Abbey. Near the Abbey, anyway. Which is a truly beautiful sight. The chapel, lie the remains of Euphemia, widow of William Stewart, Esquire of Castle Stewart in the Shire of Winton, Wigton, sixth daughter of Kenneth Lord Fortrose, son of William, fifth Earl of Seaforth. She died suddenly on the 14th of February, Valentine's Day, at age 67. The soul prepared needs no delays. The summons comes, the saint obeys. Swift was her flight, and short the road. She closed her eyes and saw her God. Good. Accent helps with that. William, eldest son of the deceased, an officer of the Royal Engineers, died in 1796 in the island of St. Domingo in the 24th year of his age. Wow, okay, that kind of sucks. His second son is named John, captain of His Majesty's ship, Seahorse, died in 1811 in the 36th year of his age and was buried in Westminster Abbey. Kenneth, the youngest son, an officer in the Royal Artillery, died in 1798 in the island of St. Vincent, in the 19th year of his age. Loving memory. Restored 1869. I don't know what that was. It's pretty crazy. Sacred to the memory of Mary, widow of Francis Lord Seaforth and daughter of the very Reverend John Baptist Proby, Dean of Litchfield, and Mary Russell, his wife. Okay. Blessed are the dead which die in the Lord. Be ye therefore followers of them who through faith and patience inherit the promises. More. This is a sort of burial area. These are facing the other way. Wide. It's open. So it's caved in or something. The stained glass is busted out. Sacred to the memory of the Right Honorable Sir John Sinclair. Baronet, born 10th May 1754. These were burial stones. Crazy. There's a door. The simple vault was built after the eastern part of this abbey church, enclosing the royal tombs, was destroyed by the English army in 1544. Here were placed the coffins of James Magdalene, his first, of James V, Magdalene, his first queen, and his infant sons by his second marriage to Mary of Guise. 1688. Some other crazy stuff has occurred. Let's pick that one. Cool. Little piece of stone. Ancient ruins. It's so cool. We're gonna try not to step too much on top of these guys. ADA. January 7th. Grace E. Sinclair. Sir John Sinclair. 7th Baronet. These are, looks like the tombs of children, though perhaps not, as the people were rather small then as well. A couple more shots here, and we'll finish up. Digging this place, man. It's cool. with that, I think there's like palace gardens to look at as well. And then we'll be all set here in Hollyrood. Do we want to take a walk about the gardens? I do believe so. At the very least. Ooh, hey, this is a pretty place. Pretty place. Crazy people. We're at the palace gardens. We're gonna take a look at. It's gonna be good. Whoa. What? Yeah. Sure.
Make your show up on this thing?
Yeah.
You can get one too.
Yeah, let's do the walkabout. Do the little walkabout.
Huh?
Oh, sorry. Flies. I haven't even looked at any of these pictures. I don't know how they're gonna turn out. As I'm walking down the row. Ooh, there's a... That's an icosahedron. Or it's close to it anyway. That's a D20. Zoom in on that. Sweet. D20. It's not really D20, but it's cool. It is super cool. It's a family. I got ahead of me because I had to stop and focus on the other thing. Royal Gardens. Yeah. Have a lot going on over here.
Yeah, you can actually see blue sky.
Misters. I don't know, I'll take a bunch of pictures. See how it goes. Some like gravel. Ooh. Hello, random statue man. Violinist. Perhaps playing a Stradivarius. Fancy, fancy violins. Pretty powerful mystery.
That's a full-time job. Find you a pineapple green.
Looks like we're coming upon the nice big open field parts. They're very cool. picturesque as it were.
Think so.
You didn't make it that sturdy?
Okay.
What a wall this is.
This is supposed to be walls? Perhaps? There's a sitting area there.
I guess those are things that are hard to do.
You get pictures in one. Flying buttresses. More Gothic architecture. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful place. This palace, Hollyrood. Yeah. We're pretty much burned through everything though. So we're going to bid you adieu. And when we next pick up, we're gonna be going to the Freemason Hall here. Hopefully I can record some stuff in there, because that would be super cool. And we'll see you later.